have to believe this. I hope you are listening. We are also fine here. We want to continue with our lesson, pattern and pattern adaptation. We finish with the unit one, where I ask you to take your body measurement. For the use of these body measurements, we are coming to use this body measurement to adapt our patterns. So on the unit two, we talk about the unit two, we talk about the pattern, and you can tell me what pattern is. The importance of pattern. So by now you can explain and you can tell me why pattern is so important. Then we also move on to the pattern making and its levels. So today I am coming to demonstrate with you how the body's block is made. Then somebody asked me, what is body's block? What is body's block? Body's block is the starting point for patterns. I believe you heard me clearly. Body's block is the starting point of patterns. We use the body's block to adapt patterns that we use on our dresses, various dresses. So at the moment, we are going to start with the bodies, we move to the skirts, then we continue with the sleeve. When I started with you, I have explained that we have five parts of pattern. We have the body front and the back, the skirt front and the back, making four, plus a sleeve, making five patterns. So we have five patterns. Body front and back, skirt front and back, and then the sleeve. That makes it five. So at the moment, we are going to start how to make the bodies grow before we move to the skirt and the sleeve. This body's block is done by using a rectangle. So we will be constructing the rectangle on the block by using some of our measurements. I told you, sewing is so dynamic. You can use any means to get what you want. It depends on you. So the measurements that I ask you to take yourself, some of you have done it well, some of you did not do it well. We are starting from the bodies. These are the few measurements that are needed for this particular purpose. All the measurements are important, but this particular one that we are going to use for the body block. So I ask you to take your measurement. Before I start, let me brief you on how to take the body measurement and a few measurements that I'm having here with me before we use them for the body block. I said bust. And the bust measurement that I am going to use right now is 40, the full bust measurement that I'm going to use. Is 40. When I divide it into 2, which is the half scale, is 20. Then I divide that one also into 4. I will get 10. Because I will be needing the half, the quarter of it also. That is why I ask you, when you take the measurement, then you divide them also. So this is how I ask you to do. Look at them. Then we have the waist. This is my waist measurement. The half of the waist measurement, the quarter of the waist measurement. The blouse length. My blouse length is 25. The half of it and then the quarter of it. So that I get to the end. So let me demonstrate one or two ways we take body measurement. Look at this. It's called mannequin. the female mannequin. Then my right here, we have the male mannequin. When you are taking the male measurement, man measurement, there's a slight difference between taking the female measurement. So we are starting from here. When it is necessary, I'll show it over there for you. So we are coming to take the bust measurement. Bust measurement. I told you in the record that when you are going to take bust measurement, you stand beside your client or the figure. Beside the client. Don't stand in front. If you stand in front, you wouldn't see what is happening at the back. And you may not be able to adjust the two sides. So you start at the front, then you put your two fingers in, then you can turn from the back to the front so that you know where the tape measure lies. So that is how we take the first measurement. Then you come down to the waist. Can you see this cord tied around the waist of your client? But please don't do it for the pregnant women. You tie this cord around the waist to determine your natural waist measurement. To determine the natural waist measurement, you tie the cord around the waist of the person. If not, you must bring the tape measure lower than this so that your dress will not look nice or higher. So that when you tie the cord around the waist, you will see the natural waist where you will be working. So wherever the cord is, you pull your dress nicely, then the cord will settle at your waist. Then you take the waist measurements. So you see, this is my 28 I have here. 28. Now, let's come to your big desk. That some of you are confused. Don't be confused. To take the hip depth measurement, you measure from where the cord is to the fullest part of the hip. That is the hip depth measurement. You measure from the cord over the side to the fullest part of the hip. That is the hip depth measurement. So this one is 9. Are you seeing it here? Hip depth measurement here is 9. So these are the few I will explain to you. If there's any other one that you still don't understand as we did it, please let me know so that I will explain more. So let's continue with the basic block. Basic bodies block. I'm using my body. Basic bodies block. Before we start, let us do our rectangle. The rectangle that is going to help us to get the half of our body measurement. Let us start. So you rule a straight line. Rule a straight line. This straight vertical line, you are going to use it to represent the length of your blouse. The length of your blouse. So you take a measurement of your blouse. That is the line here. So let's come to the measurement. Our blouse length is 25. So we take the measurement and see. Exactly 25. Here is it. So this is the mark at the top. This is the 25 at the bottom. 25. line is representing the length of your blouse. Then the next thing you do is to square across. So we are going to square it across here. You square across. You don't just square across. You square across with some a measurement. What measurement? What are we using for this cross? We are using our half bust measurement. Half bust measurement. Because when you are going to make a blouse, you need bust measurement for your major measurements. So we are using half bust measurement. So what is our half bust measurement here? It's 20. So we are going to take the measurement and take exactly 20 inches. This is 20 inches. So from here to here is 20. The length here is representing the length of your blouse. Then this is taking the half, a full front or back of your blouse here. That's what we want there. But we cannot just leave it like that. We have to be naming all the points. So the first point here, I am naming it 0. Then the down here is 1. This place is 2. Are you seeing the L shape that we have? We need to square it out. So we are coming to square this L. We have 25 here. We bring that same 25 here. Don't forget, we use 20 inches for the half bust measurement. So 20 is here. We are going to connect this 20 now. We have gotten our rectangle. It's a measurement. If you don't take your measurement well, at the end of it all, you may not be able to get what you want. So make sure you take for accurate measurement to do this rectangle before you can get your dress properly. Now, we are starting with the lines that we need to construct the dress. Those lines that we need to construct the dress. Now, if you look at this figure here, this mannequin here, you can see some various points in the figure. Then somebody said, this place, we first have the shoulder parts. We all have the human being hands. It's one line. Then when you come to the bust, another line is there, the waist, another line is there, the hip side, another one line is there. It continues. So, we are going to look for all those lines to construct our work. So now, let's come down to look for our waist, shoulder to waist measurement, shoulder to the waist measurement. The zero here is the zero line to two here is representing our shoulder line. So we are counting from there, from the shoulder to the waist measurement. Then let's come to the board to see where we get the shoulder to waist. I said shoulder to the waist. But when we come here, we will not see anything shoulder to waist. We will see something like neck to the waist. If I said neck, I'm not confusing you. The first bone here, everybody is having it. The first bone here is called neck. When you are wearing shirts, that is where it starts. This is your uniform that you are wearing. Look at the back. The back is higher. It's at the neck. So this is the neck we call, the neck to the waist. So we are using this zero as the neck. So we are going to measure from this neck down our neck to waist measurement. Our neck to waist here is 16. Can you see? 16. So we are using the 16 for our neck to the waist. Don't forget, do the same thing here. For the work to go smoothly for you, whatever you do here, you do it at the other side. 16. When you finish, connect them together. Join them together. So this is our waist line. Our waist line. So there's someone who asks us, how do we determine our waist line? We measure from the zero down to get our neck to waist. That is our waist line. Now we are looking for our bust line here. This is our bust line. We are looking for it here. What do we do? You divide the zero to this point, which is 3. No, it's 4. Here is 3. Here is 4. 0 to 4 into 2. So I'm going to do just that. At the other side. Then you connect. So that line is your bust line. This particular is your bust. Not all. We need another line called across line. Across line for the ladies or female. We measure, you look at me, where my arm joint here to the other side is called across. So you measure it here to here. That's across chest. But if I said across back, we go to the back and that same position, we measure it also there. Note that we have different figures. Some figures are stupid. When the person is like this and we take the across measurement, the back will be bigger or wider than the front. Across line that we are looking for right now. So we have the bust or chest, across chest, and we have across back. For women, we measure it here, where your arm John to the other side is where we measure our cross measurements. But if it comes to female, people put the tape measure there and cross it like this. You see, at the back like this, that is what they call a cross. But when it comes to female, why the arm joint is our cross chest and then the back. That is where you measure. So you come here, you measure, you go to the back to measure where the arm joint. Note that they are not the same. Nobody, no figure has it the same. Everybody's own, everybody has his own. Some people's own are more wider at the back and narrow at the front. So know that you take the front segment and take the back segment. So when you come to the measurement chart here, you can see my across back 15, but across chest 14. So I'm telling you they are not the same. They vary all the time. So we are going to look for that line, across line. To determine the across line, you will measure from zero to six and divide it into two. We have it eight, so half of it is four. Do the same here. Then you connect. So we said across line. These are the important, very important lines that we need in this particular way. We have the shoulder line, across line, shoulder line, across line, bust line, waist line, and then the bottom one is hip line. So now we have gotten the rectangle and the lines that are necessary for us to work on it. So now we are starting the work fully. Just a line you are seeing. We are going to use this vertical line as a center back, and then the vertical line here as a center front. So you write here center back. When you check the template I sent to you, it is written on this. Center back and then the center front. So now your back dress are coming to this side, and then the front dress are coming to this side, and they all meet together. Now let's start. From this zero here, in measure 2.5 inches. Then you come down 1/8. The other time I taught you how we write 1/8. We write it 1/8. So you come down 1/8. Then you connect by using your French curve. I taught you people about these tools that we use to do our pattern drafting. They are all here. Each of them use perform different tasks. So you are going to take this French curve, then you take it to where you mark. One of the marks is here, one is also here. Then make sure that you turn the French curve nicely so that so this is our neck. Back neckline. Back neckline. That is not all on this back line. We need your shoulder length measurement plus a dot, a small dot at the back of your shoulder. So we are going to create that line also. So this one, I'm going to use your straight ruler to do that way. So measure from your neck edge here. So this one becomes your neck edge. So we are going to name it, this is 7. Here is 8. This place is 9. So this one will be 10. 11 will come here. We are numbering it ourselves so that it won't miss. So we are going to take a measurement from the 10 here towards the shoulder line. Your shoulder length measurement. Let's come here to see the shoulder length measurement. This is shoulder length measurement. So like 5. So you measure 5 inches over there. After getting the point there, come down 1 inch. Then somebody ask me why. You will come down 1 inch. That is not all. We need a dart there. So we need to add the dart ease. I mean dart allowance. If any time I use the word ease, means allowance. So we add a dart ease of 3/4 to it. It's not 3/4 is not half 1 inch. It's 3/4. It's not that 1 inch. You add 3/4 to it. So making 5/3. Then your 1 inch down. Let me connect it. After connecting it, then somebody will ask me, why do you bring 1 inch down? If you will not ask me, I will not tell you. You see? Meaning that our shoulders are not straight like robots. Our shoulders are a bit slanted. That is why we have to drop this shoulder. I drop it 1 inch. Don't forget, all the time, you don't cut shoulder very straight like a robot. No. So make it slanted. You drop it 1 inch. We've added 3/4 to it. We want to create that in it. So you know what? These 5/3, we are going to divide it into 2 to create the dart there. So from here to here, 2.5. Then we put the 3/4 in. You see? Then we want the dart to be 3 inches. The dart length should be 3 inches. So you come down 3 inches. Then you connect. Now, this is what we need at the shoulder line. Let's come to the across line. On the across line, when we come here, we are working at the center back. So we'll come to back across measurement. Back across measurement is 15. So we are going to divide it into two. So we are going to use 7.5 on the across line. So that is 7.5. The first shoulder line ends here, then across line ends here. So we finish on the across line for the back, a center back. Let's come down to the bust line. We are going to take quarter of our bust measurement. So when you look at it, the quarter of our bust measurement is 10. Quarter of our bust measurement is 10. So you take your measurement. If your measurement is 40, you divide it into 2 to get half. To get the quarter is 10. So here is 10. So we can see some points here. Some points here. It's telling us something. So that is our armhole curving over there. So I'm going to use your armhole head. This is your armhole head. This armhole can be called arm side. Arm side. So this arm side curve to curve our armhole nicely. So you look at the way I use this armhole, then you also do the same. You just turn it. So this is our angle. You make sure you put the points. You place it on the point, then you curve. That is our angle. It's up to the bust line. Let's continue with the waist line. Waist line. What is our waist measurement? Our waist measurement is here. Our waist measurement is 28. Half of it is 4, but we need quarter of it. Quarter of your waist measurement. Don't forget, there is a dart. We always put that on our waist to fit us nicely. So we are going to create the dart there. Anytime you want to adapt any dress, you can use it. So we will be adding 1.5 inches to the waist measurement. So here we are having 7 plus 1.5, making 8.5. Okay. Then you forget. Don't forget to use the curved rulers for the side. Use a straight ruler for your side. I'm going to collect it. So are you seeing? We are moving on. The 1.5 is in. This is not our normal waist measurement, including the dart. So we are going to form the dart after we finish with the hip. So let's quickly come to the hip. We have hip measurements is here. Hip measurements is here. quarter of it is 10. So we are going to measure a quarter of our hip measurement. But you know, hip, all ladies have a contour hair. Our hip are not straight, so you can use straight ruler to measure, to rule that place. So we have a hip curve. I believe you all have it. Hip curve. That is what you use to curve that place nicely. So you see how I'm holding it. There we go. So this is our hip. Then we added that to the waistline. We did not add anything to the bust, neither the hip. The dart will start from the bust line and end at the hip line. But the fold affects only the waist. So you don't need to add anything here. For the bust and the hip, when you start stitching, you will start pointed and fold it at the waist and pointed towards the hip. So you are not going to add anything to that place. So let's construct our hip. How do we construct that? And get the dart at the such the normal place of your client. Look at your client. Your dart must be at the right place. This is your school uniform. Here is one of the darts. One is also here. To determine where your dart should be, you measure nipple to nipple. Nipple to nipple. That is where the darts are. So you measure that place. Measure yours and see. Mine is 8. What is here? The mannequin here is also 8. It depends on your stature. That's before you can determine the dart point. So these 8 are bottom. I'll divide it into 2. Then you lose it. So I'm measuring 4. I said I divided my nipple to nipple that I got 8. I divide it into 2 to get 4. Then you do the same at the waistline, the same at the hip line. Then you rule. Very straight. Are you seeing? Now, the allowance that has been added to the waistline, for the darts, we are now going to use it. We said we've added 1.5 inches. When you divide 1.5 into 2, you are going to get 3/4, 3/4. 1 and 1.5 divided into 2, you are going to get 3/4. Now, we are going to measure here 3/4 of an inch, each size of this point. Each side of this point, 3/4 is there. Then you now shape your dart. Or as you start the dart first. Now, we are making the dart in this. The dart is, don't forget, we have added 1.5 inches to these darts. The 1.5 that we have added, you measure your nipple to nipple. That is the center line here. Then you divide the 1.5 into 2 to have 3/4. You measure each side of it. Then you collect and rule the line for your darts. Now, we want to continue with the front bodies. Center front bodies. We finish with the center back bodies. So we are moving to the center front. Before that, let us finish with the numbering. The numbering. We say here is 11. So here will be 12. Here 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. That's the numbering. So we are moving on to the front. So we are starting from here. We will measure from the 2, the point 2 over here, in 1.5 inches. Don't forget, when we are doing the back, we measure from the 0 in to the 10 here, 2.5. They should meet at the end of the way. So you have to take the same measurement. But here is the front. You measure from the 2 down 3 inches. 2 down 3 inches. Then you use your French curve to connect your neckline. Your French curve to connect the line. Because it's at the curve area. So you connect this two together. So we will say that here is 19, 20, 1 minute. We need shoulder length on this shoulder line. The shoulder length on this shoulder line. So you measure from 20 in 5 inches. Don't forget, we have shoulder length 5 inches. Then you drop it 1 inch. You roll it with a straight ruler. So this is your shoulder length. That's not all. We move to the across line. Our across chest. Now we are at the front. So it's called chest. When we were at the back, we say across back. Now we are at the front, across chest. Across chest measurement is 14, half is 7. So we measure 7 here. Now that is your across chest measurement. Let's move to the bust line. Our bust line, the quarter that we are using is 10, so we measure. The 10, have you seen that it has met? If you have done yours and it did not meet, then there's something wrong with your measurement because we are using exactly half of your measurement to construct this. So they should meet. Good. So now we are going to curve our angle. our angle for the front. Angle for the front. Now, the waistline, let's come to the waistline. You measure quarter of your waistline, 7, plus that 1.5 for the dart. When you finish, you connect. The hip measurement. We said our hip measurement is 40, the quarter is 10. We are coming here to take the 10 at the bottom. Have you seen that one also has met? This word did not meet, meaning you are having a great problem. So look at your measurements. This is our hip also. We are going to form our dart at the front also. As usual, your nipple to nipple. Mine was 8, so 4, 4, 4. Then you connect. Connect. Then we are going to measure the 3/4 each side. The 3/4 each side of these that are the waistline as we dig to the back. We have it at the back, as well as the back shoulder dart. So we are going to continue numbering our points. So here is 20, 21, 22, 23. Then we come here 24, then here 25. These are our basic bodies block, our basic
body's blood.
Take note, if you have any other problem, forward it on our platform and I will answer you. The shoulder line, across line, bust line, waist line, then a hip line. I believe you can see clearly. Good. We finish with the body's block. We will continue with the sleeve and the skirt block. That one is not difficult. It's very simple. Thank you.